This is D.Va from Overwatch and Blizzard Collectibles, also known as the world-renowned esports champion Hannah Song. She comes in a 29.5 by 18 by 15.5 inch box that weighs 40 pounds or about 18 kilograms. The figure itself is about 20 inches tall when fully assembled and has magnetic joints to make everything a bit easier. But some joints might need glue added to them just in case. The whole thing sits atop a heavily weighted base with solid connections to ensure that it won't fall over, this being accompanied with the trademark Overwatch logo engraved into it. The pose of the figure is modeled after the sitting victory pose in-game, and it is a nice balance between how cute, badass, and sassy D.Va is. It does a good job of both showcasing the character as well as her mecha in its idle pose. The sculpting and details are pretty good, but not great. That said, we will start with all the things that work pretty well. The mecha has silver bolts throughout its construction to show how it is all held together, and pistons in the joints indicating how it maneuvers. Chipped paint, scratches, and dirt can be found throughout the figure to show the wear of the mech. This can also be found on the two turrets, but with a burnt tone around the barrels to show the artillery that travels through them. This leading to the detailed triggers / joysticks that control the mecha and guns. The mech also features a large plastic windshield that allows you to peer into the modeled interior that shows how Hannah is held in place as she pilots. D.Va and the mech are also covered in detail sponsorships that are easily legible. Unfortunately, even with all these details, there is still a lot to be loathed about this figure. This is mostly found in the painting, which is inconsistent and messy to say the least. The mech doesn't really have any gloss to it, which is somewhat fine seeing how the in-game model is similar, but even the parts that are shown to be brushed metal lack a shine. Some of the chips and dirt along the paint are also messy and unconvincing. Paints bleed over into one another throughout the model too. Hannah's gloves and face are a mess up close, and this is also hindered by the lack of gradient and shading throughout. All this adds up to come across as a flat paint job. There really isn't any difference between the materials, and it all kind of melds together looking the same. That said, the figure isn't terrible at a distance, and because of the scale, most of the time you won't be viewing it super up close. Once again, with the Blizzard collectibles, the overall piece ends up with a garage kit feel to it, which isn't for everyone. And coupled with the $450 price tag, this figure is pretty much for no one. While I'm not angry to have this figure in my collection, I can't really recommend it to anyone due to the paint job and the price tag. The overall scale of it helps, and it is guaranteed to wow anyone who sees it, but it is still a hard sell to be made. All I can say is I hope Blizzard's Overwatch figures become better, but with this being the second in my collection and both of them having a lot of the same issues, it is tough for me to see things changing in the future. Otaku Reviews videos are made possible by generous viewers just like you. If you enjoy what you see, check out patreon.com/otakureviews to see more videos and exclusive content, and consider becoming a patron to help us make more. Also, like, comment, and subscribe to help our channel's community grow. Hey everyone, we will be doing our first lotto giveaway on Patreon soon. The first thing we will be giving away is this official plushie squid from Splatoon 2. If you would like to be entered to have a chance to win this prize, all you have to do is become a patron at the $5 level. Once we have 50 people at that level, I will randomly pick a name out of the patrons and contact them to send them the prize. So, if you are interested, become a patron at that level to automatically be entered to win.